Welcome. Today, we'll be discussing properties of parallelograms, and we're going to concentrate on rectangles. But let's take a look at the first property that we have here. We want to show that diagonals in a rectangle are congruent. Well, let's start with the figure that we're working with, a rectangle. Let's put down the information that we know about rectangles. In a rectangle, we know that all interior angles are of 90 degrees. And in addition, we know that opposite sides are congruent to each other. Let's draw our diagonal of AC. And notice by introducing this diagonal, we have created a right triangle. Let's actually draw this triangle on the side. And let's put down the information that you know about this triangle. We know that angle B, it's of 90 degrees. And in addition, notice that BC has a double mark from the rectangle and BA has one mark from the rectangle. Let's introduce diagonal BD. And we have the same conclusion. We have also created another right triangle. Here we have right triangle BAD. Let's put this triangle on the side. Now let's put down what we know about this triangle. We know that angle A, it's of 90 degrees, and we know that BA has one mark and AD has two marks. Let me actually highlight them using the same colors. Now let's think about what we know about these two triangles. Notice that these two triangles are congruent to each other. How so? Notice that we have side, we have angle, and we have side. So therefore, our conclusion is that triangle CBA is congruent to triangle DAB. And if that's the case, due to CPCTC, so therefore, corresponding part of AC is going to be congruent to corresponding part of BD. And this is what we wanted to show, because notice that these two line segments are the diagonals. So we have shown that diagonals in any rectangle are going to be congruent. Now let's take a look at another property. So here we want to show, when is a parallelogram a rectangle? What conditions need to be fulfilled for us to say that a parallelogram is a rectangle? Well, let's assume that we do not know that the left-hand side figure is a rectangle. The only thing that we know is that we have a parallelogram. Well, if the left-hand side is a parallelogram, we know certain things. We know that opposite sides are congruent to each other. That's a property of a parallelogram. And then, in addition, we know that opposite sides are also parallel to each other. Well, let's say that there is one angle whose measure is 90 degrees. If one of the angles has a measurement of 90 degrees, then this is sufficient information for us to claim that the parallelogram is a rectangle. Because remember that in a parallelogram, consecutive angles are supplementary. And if that's the case, if angle D is of 90 degrees, then therefore angle C must be of 90 degrees. Because notice that they are consecutive, they're right next to each other. And if you already have 90, then the other angle that is needed to add up to 180 is 90. And notice that we can also say the same about angle B. If angle C is of 90 degrees, then angle B is of 90 degrees as well. They're consecutive, they're supplementary. And if angle B is of 90 degrees, then angle A is of 90 degrees as well. And now notice that we have shown enough information for us to make a claim that this is a rectangle, because in a rectangle, opposite sides are congruent to each other. Which we got that property by noting that this was a parallelogram. And the second property was that interior angles are of 90 degrees. And we got that by noticing that it is sufficient to just have one angle that is 90 for all angles to be of 90 degrees. We have fulfilled these two conditions, then we can claim that this parallelogram is a rectangle. Hello, if you would like to continue to learn about mathematics, you can check out the videos on the left.